medical. Yeah, my name's J.P. Bell. Variety of things, but I'm going to have PTSD. I was recently diagnosed. A very well-known doctor, you may have heard of him. Dr. Webb, M.D., another doctor. So anyway, my regular doctor, I was trying to get treatment. I was talking to my GP, and I'm, trying to get a psychiatrist. She said, it takes 6 months. I'm like, I can't wait that long. She says, okay, here's what you do. You go off your meds, and then you lose your job, and you'll qualify for emergency care. And I'm like, doc, I can't do that. I work for a huge multinational. HR is literally in Puerto Rico. It'll take them 3.5 years to fire me if I was standing on my desk naked shouting my UFOs. Okay, because if I put a mental disability card, they can't do anything. They just kick me upstairs, give me a rubber office with a cot and a bucket and a computer with Windows 95 just to make sure I don't accidentally do something useful. Eventually, I figure I'd probably become VP of Vision Initiative until the UFOs finally find me. So, the other thing I have is depression, and what I really hate about depression is it's not cool, it's not sexy, it's a common cold, it's a illness. Really, it's a common cold. And, why can't I have something cool, like sociopathic homicidal tendencies? Everybody loves Dexter, everybody loves Hannibal Lecter. You don't hear about, Eeyore in prison, and Wendell Rockford, and Harry Potter. You've probably never heard of that. How did you end up in prison? The 100-acre-wood classic, Eeyore Shanks a Snitch. That's interesting. In prison, you don't stab people, you shank them, and you don't use a dagger or a knife, you use a shiv. This is a handcrafted project. I think that's why Martha Stewart did really well when she was inside. She raised the bar on artisanal prison murder. That's not a saran wrap knife with a little bit of raffia bone. That's a good thing. What comes after that? Oh, yeah. So, Ed Bird, apropos of nothing, his name is Harvey. He's a lineated parakeet, and he hates me. Lineated, by the way, is Latin for a sharp-beaked bastard. So one day I was looking at my phone and I was reading Twitter or something and I was distracted. I was trying to feed him and he bit me really hard and I dropped the phone and ADT is another thing, so I just kind of forgot I tried to feed him. I had to go to work. And while I was there, he calls in a suicide threat to a mental health emergency. By the time I was trying to explain the book, it wasn't me, it's the bird, but I did not have to wait 6 months. So, eventually I did get to see Dr. Reed, really his name, not a joke, and he downgraded my depression to disappointment. This is the name. I looked it up on Google. Literally, the whole definition is persistent mild depression. That's not a disorder, you're just a goth. Side effects include misaligned eyeliner, and an empty British accent, and an inability to hold down a job, except the pop topic. Okay, no other goths in the U.S. Alright, I'm originally from Albuquerque, New Mexico. I keep up with the news there. Recently, the Justice Department actually was investigating APD for their shooting of mentally ill people. Just it keeps on happening. Enough to draw that attention. Yeah, it's true, sad story. And so I'm glad I got out of there, right? Where they just tase your customs. Well, we can't do that. Okay. I went over this routine. It's like, it's pretty wild. But I got more. So, my classmates were always telling me, your jokes are too much. You dumb gentleman, man. And I thought they were just ragging on me. And one time I came to class and there was a gift certificate in my seat. Oh, how nice. For a frontal lobotomy. They got another group on. I think it might be okay. I talked to talked to the doctor about it, and he said, well, there's some risk if there's any sort of difficulty that you might end up as a newscaster when you're done. And I heard that one guy that screwed up really bad, and he did a lot of damage over the time, and we've only recently managed to get him out of office. So another thing in the U.S. that is just amazing, I'm sure we're at the school shootings, that's terrible, and they also have an average of a little more than once a week a toddler shoot someone. I'm not making this up. Naturally, the NRA came out with a statement about this, that it bore this violence, but really, the only defense against a bad toddler with a gun